One of our frequently asked questions about IVF is, when is the egg retrieval? The answer is a little more complicated than you think. Stay tuned and I'll show you actual data from my practice from hundreds of patients. The IVF egg retrieval is typically done under anesthesia. This means that you will need to be off of work or school on that day, the whole day. It would be nice to know when that day is going to be so you can plan ahead. As an IVF specialist, I want to do the egg retrieval at the perfect time. I want the eggs to have had time to mature. After my patients start their fertility medication injections, I will start bringing them back to the office for blood tests and ultrasounds. Remember that each egg is in a little cyst called a follicle. When the eggs are maturing, the follicles grow larger. We can see and measure this on ultrasound. The follicles also produce estrogen, which we can measure with blood tests. Using this information, we will determine the correct time to do the egg retrieval. It isn't necessarily going to be the same from one patient to the next, or even for one patient from one attempt to the next. At my practice, most women will need between 9 and 12 days of fertility medications. This means that most women will have an egg retrieval 11 to 14 days from the first day of fertility medications. The egg retrieval is always on the second day after the last fertility injection. Notice, however, that some women only needed 7 days of medication, and some needed 17 or 18 days. For planning purposes, it's pretty difficult to predict the exact day of the egg retrieval before you start your injections. The closer you get, the more accurately you can predict. So a couple of days beforehand, I will have a pretty good idea when you will have your egg retrieval. Now that you know when the IVF egg retrieval will occur, it is time to learn what you can do to maximize your chances for first-time IVF success. Check out this playlist right now. But before you go, be sure to like this video. If you have a question or an idea for a future episode, leave it in the comments. And you should definitely subscribe to Infertility TV now for new episodes weekly. It's like having a fertility specialist in your phone.